quarantine Fort City for safety precautions. Ramirez has also denied that the strange mist surrounding the area is toxic, citing general panic as the source of this rumor. Sarah Goldberg reporting.
Listen to this guy. Why isn't he flying over this place then?
Geez, you said it.
Still, what the hell are we doing out here? And what the hell is in that damn box? They got us flying over toxic freaking fumes. And for what?
Emergency pizza delivery.
Huh? What the hell was that?
The beast is taking over your mind. You're going to die unless we do something.
What's happening to me? Who are you?
You don't remember? Don't worry, it's just a tranquilizer. Transformation puts quite a bit of stress on your cerebral cortex. That's the human part of your brain. We don't want your mind to transform as well, do we?
Transform? What are you talking about?
I don't suppose you would have the chips with you like you're supposed to. Though, I doubt that in your current state you even know what I'm talking about.
Wait! Damn!
What? I assume you've already been debriefed on the situation in Forret Town. I need you to investigate the research facility and confirm the fate of Dr. Eric Jobes and his research team. Sorry, but you're on your own on this one. You're the only one who can survive in that genome mist. Seeing as you are still highly classified, you will be transported under secrecy. As for the chips you'll be carrying with you, feel free to administer them using your own discretion. Remember, we haven't tested the effects of administering all the chips simultaneously, so don't get too trigger happy.
Thank you. Yeah! increased endurance, strength, and reactive transformation abilities. You've passed all the tests with flying colors. I finally succeeded! You are the ultimate genome cyborg! This chip contains the genetic information of a wolf. With it, you will be able to transform into something more than human!
We'll be right back. Doctor, how much longer do you plan to keep us waiting?
Well, well. Welcome, everyone. I just want to personally thank you for taking time out of your busy schedule to visit us.
Dispense with the pleasantries, Doctor. Show us what we're here for.
Very well, then. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the results of our long and sometimes questionable experiments. Rest assured, your money has not gone to waste. When normal creatures inhale this genome mist, their cells rapidly mutate, and they become, well, rather violent.
Can the genome cyborgs operate in the presence of this whatever mist?
Ah, yes. They were developed with the assumption that they'd need to be able to withstand the genome mist. Sort of. Unfortunately, not even genome cyborgs can withstand genome mist when in high enough concentrations.
Looks like we just need to be a little cautious when using it then.
Grown strong. But next time shall be your last.
Thank you.
I bet you've got a million questions for me. Where do I start? Project Altered Beast was an experiment funded by the Army and was kept secret from all but the top officials in Washington. The goal of the project was to create a type of genetic cyborg, or genome cyborg as we call them, that could absorb genetic material from various animals and work it into their own DNA. These soldiers could use the abilities of those animals to aid them in battle. It took many years and many failures, but the experiment eventually succeeded. The result of the project is you. And another who was responsible for releasing the genome mist into the city. Brad. He is seeking the most powerful genome chip. I hate to think about what he'd do if he got his hands on it. He'd be unstoppable.
Wait, I don't even know who you are.
My name is Anastasia. I used to work for Dr. Eric Jobs.
Yeah.
Where are you going?
I am no longer needed here. It is pointless for me to stay.
Don't think you'll get out of here alive with any genome chips.
I don't care if you're a Chimera type or some sort of new model. Nobody tells me what to do. More powerful. And yet, why did they choose you?
I knew you would come. This is Dragon, the legendary beast of destruction. You shall not have it! Do you still feel the pain from the wound that I gave you? Come, let me put you out of your misery. Chosen.
Why did you release the genome mist?
Me? Have you not yet realized the truth? You must stop Anastasia. There is still time.
So, how are you feeling? Don't try to get up just yet. Your body hasn't recovered. I don't know if you remember, but you were mortally wounded in your last mission. We recovered your body and rebuilt you as the third genome cyborg.
Genome cyborg?
It's a little difficult to explain, but, well, using what we call a genome chip, you can temporarily alter your genetic structure to mimic those of specific animals. Let me introduce you to another genome cyborg, Brad. And another, Anastasia.
Call me Anna. Nice to meet you.
Anna.
Looks like you got your memory back.
You're a genome cyborg.
Yes, same as you. I was the second one created, right after Brad. It's all because of you. Once you were developed, Brad and I were deemed unnecessary. Brad was the first genome cyborg to successfully undergo transformation. He had amazing combat prowess, and showed the limitless potential of the entire project. The experiment then moved on to phase two, the goal of which was to create a chimera-type genome cyborg. One that would combine the genomes of multiple beasts. That was me. But my system was flawed. Eric's interest in me lasted only for a short while. The project quickly moved on to the final phase. The creation of the ultimate genome cyborg who could freely control multiple genomes. That's when Eric became obsessed with you! Hey, Eric. He's obtained the dragon genome, just like you always dreamed about.
Dragon must analyze research.
All I had to do was release the genome mist, and I knew they'd send you. I knew you'd come. Well, I didn't think you'd have lost your memory, though. I may not be able to use genome chips like you, but I can absorb your DNA. With your power, I can become the ultimate genome cyborg that Eric has been looking for! Eric, just you wait and see!
Your very existence has driven her mad. You do not know what it means to be cast aside. Forgotten. I knew you and Eric would destroy her. Yet I could do nothing. With all my power, I was helpless to stop this. You must kill Anastasia. It's the only way.